of some of our children from the children's section to the youth section. Can we give a clap offering to Jesus? Can we give a clap? You can do better. As the clap offering is going on to heaven, I want the children to start marching in. Our children leaders should please guide the children to the front section. While we have a hymn or a rendition to usher them in. Hymn 178. We'll be taking hymn 179 to usher in the children. Hymn 179. Let's all rise to our feet.
Yeah!
praise the living Jesus. We can all have our seats. I'm so happy and joyful to preside over this few moments to usher in our children to the youth. And it's a very wonderful moment. Amen. You know, the children have actually been in the children's church for a while. And their leaders, God has given them the wisdom and the grace to bring up these children, joint combined efforts with the parents and the way of the Lord. And by God's grace, we can see that the glory of God is radiating through them. Amen. So briefly, we would want our children leader to just come forward and just... the church has a gift for the children. So before we hand them over finally to our youth leaders, we want our children leader to come up and pick up the gift for each of the children. So we just have like 1 to 2 minutes. Our children leader, just give us a brief speech before you hand over the gift to each of the children. And then our youth leader would receive the children from the children leader.
Praise the Lord, church. By the grace of God, today we are having our graduating children today. And the Lord accepted. So the church is giving a gift. So go to the next person. First person. Okay, to the next. Thank you very much, church. Also, the choir mistress also have a gift to give to them.
Okay, praise the Lord. You can give our youth leader the mic. Because of our time, we would have loved each of them to give us a brief of themselves, their names, but because of our time, we are just going to hand them over to the youth leader. So our youth leader, the children church is so delighted, and the church as a whole is so delighted to hand over these children. You know, a transition, a new phase of their life is about to begin in the youth church. And as God has been helping you to look over the youth spiritually and in other ways, we believe that God will also give you more grace. So please, these are the children that are presented to you formally today, and accept them into the youth church. So I don't know whether you have something to just...
Praise the Lord! Happy half of the youth ministry. I want to say a very thank you to the children teachers. We have been praying unto us. And now, to the glory of God, we have a whole 6 of them. Can we give Jesus a good hand of applause? So I want to join our parents. Please get literatures for them. Our higher every day. They search the scripture booklets. Please endeavor to get for them. And encourage them to be present in the house fellowship. Because that is the only place we can relate with them one-on-one and know what is happening to them in their academics. We don't talk only about the Bible in the house fellowship, but their academic life and other aspects of their life. I pray that as we comply, we work together as a team, and the Lord will take them to greater heights in Jesus' name. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma. Our youth, please, we need to evacuate that place to the back because our children have to take the front row. Amen. Church, amen. So youth, please move to the back while our children come to the front. While the photograph is going on briefly, the church once again says, welcome to the youth church. Can we do better for Jesus? It takes a community to bring up a child. It takes a community to bring. Now we are, it is the community of the body of Christ, and there should be a much more different. You know, as they've come and we've received them, it takes all of us collective responsibility to watch over them spiritually and physically. Some of them will be writing exams. Do you care to know the stage they are in their education? You know, they are on the same street with you. When you see them where they are not supposed to be, you have the right to call them. You have the right to put them on the right way. And as God has even seen them to this extent, God will see them further in Jesus' name. Let's close our eyes briefly as we pray for them. Just open your mouth and tell God that as this one has begun to work with God from a tender age, nothing will pluck them away from the kingdom of God. Every agenda of this present generation to sift them away like weeds from the glory of God, that God will frustrate those plans. Open your mouth and tell God that as they've been handed over to the youth church, when we, after 3, 4, 5 years, when we come back to check them, none of them will be found missing. We'll not see them in the world. We'll not see them in areas where they're supposed not to be. That has been handed over to the youth, that the glory of God will continually multiply in their life. Their Christian experiences will remain intact, and God will help them to grow in faith, in love, in joy, in righteousness and holiness. They'll be useful instruments in the hand of God, a useful tool in the hand of God. God will give them the grace. In their academics, they shall excel. In their spiritual life, they shall mount up with wings like eagles. Open your mouth and intercede for them. And they will be marked for excellence. The excellent spirit, the Holy Ghost that rested upon Daniel will be multiplied upon their life. Open your mouth and tell God. In Jesus' name we pray. Heavenly Father, we bless your name for the gift you've given to us, the children, which, you know, you are so delighted and happy with. I will ask Heavenly Father that even as they've graduated to the youth, they will graduate in all aspects of their life to better levels in Jesus' name. You know, from this point, certain attitude of childishness, you know, they will overgrow it and come to a place of maturity in knowing Christ in Jesus' name. Lord, we ask, oh God, every influence of peer pressure from the community, from the school, anywhere, we ask, oh God, that you give them a mind of Christ, a mind of decisions to stand for the right way in Jesus' name. God of all flesh, we commit them and we seal them with the New Testament covenant blood, the Lamb, the blood of Jesus. And we ask, oh God, that these ones are marked for good, for excellence, for prosperity, for greatness in the name of Jesus. Every contrary opinion against their growth, against their health, against their academics, against their spiritual life will frustrate those plans in the name of Jesus. King of all flesh, we also ask for their parents that the resources to bring up these children you made available in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, we pray.